Good morning, all of you. A very happy new year to everyone. So let us start the first class of this year. So today let us discuss about linear regression. So in the last week we have before vacation we have discussed about the basics, introduction to what is machine learning and deep learning. So we'll continue with the next part of the machine learning concept, that is linear regression. So in the introduction slide, I have covered the basics of machine learning, and then there are several types of classifiers that are used for classification purpose. And then based on the errors that are happening during the classification process, how to overcome the errors, and then how many times we have to repeat the process, training, etc. All those are basically given in those slides, and in the subsequent classes we'll be discussing later more in detail about that. I hope you would have gone through those introduction slides. So now today let us start with the linear regression topic. So before going into this linear regression, let us discuss basically what is regression and what are its application and why it is used. Okay, the purpose. Fine. Suppose, for example, in the earlier class, we have discussed about identifying colors, shapes, and so many things, isn't it? So if you are given certain set of objects and if you have to identify, say, for example, you have a machine, it has to identify the gender, boy or a girl. And then it has to define it based on the images that are fed to the system real time. Okay. And then say, for example, the apples or oranges, it has to classify, or even the salmon and sea bass fishes, it has to classify. So basically, when you have two categories of fishes or two categories of fruits, then all the input data elements or the input samples has to be categorized into two classes, either this or that. So whenever you have to define the elements into one of the given classes, then it is basically called as a classification. And when you have only two classes, it is called binary. Suppose if you have more than two classes and then your incoming objects or the images has to be classified. Say, for example, is a person is expressing emotions, six basic emotions, anger, happy, disgust, sad, neutral, surprise, fear, etc. Then there will be more than two. So in that case, it is multi-class classification. So whenever an input image is given, if it has and a person is expressing any of the emotion, and it has to be classified. And if there are multiple classes, then the image will be classified into one of those given classes. So that is multiple category classification. So whenever you have an input data and it has to be stored into or categorized into certain classes, quantities, then it is called as a classification problem. Okay, fine. Now, let us see what is regression. For example, suppose based on my experience, how much salary will I get if I want to calculate? Okay, suppose I have 10 years experience. Now, if I want to know what is the salary that I will get, or if someone has 20 years experience and then if they want to know what is the salary that I get, that is one example. And suppose for getting admission into a university, this is my marks. And based on, say, for example, you are applying for a MS or any other degree for a particular college, and this is my BTech CGPA, and this is my GATE score, this is my GRE score, TOEFL score, or whatever it is, any higher studies that you want to apply. So based on the past record, last year for this particular score in this college, in this particular specialization, a seat was given. So likewise, whenever you want to know something, will I get a seat here, or what could be the salary? Or suppose you want to buy a house and then you are looking at the trend. Okay, every year the land value increases, the house value increases, and then if you want to know in this particular square feet in this year, how much was the price that was sold. So when you see from 2000 onwards, every year in this particular locality, the price is increasing, and sometimes it is decreasing also. So this happens. So if you want to buy a house in a particular area with particular square feet, if you want to see the past data, based on the old data, you can just look at it and see, okay, for given this particular square feet, what could be the price I want to find out. So this we call it as a prediction. Okay, I hope it is clear between classification and prediction. Classification means identifying the input data into one of the given set of predefined classes, and prediction means given a data, you want to know what could be the value of something. Okay, so for example, if I give Celsius, I can determine Fahrenheit. Okay, if I give voltage and resistance, I can determine the current, isn't it? So if I give diameter, I can find the circumference of a circle. So those things are predictions or calculations, you can say. So any predictions is basically called as a regression problem, and any classification or identifying, those are called as classification problem. Okay, so now when coming to this regression, basically there are several types of regression, and linear, logistic, and so on. So today we are going to discuss about linear regression, and we also call it as a, we give the definition like this: it is a statistical method to study the relationship between two continuous variables. So there are certain keywords here, so let us have a discussion on that. First of all, here it says a statistical method, and it says two and also continuous. So let us discuss on these three: why it is a statistical method, and why only two, and why it is continuous. Okay, so when you say statistical, what is statistical? Apart from statistical, is there any other method to study the relationship? Yes, there is another method, as I said before, that is deterministic method. Like voltage V equal to IR. So if you want to predict current, then you can just write like this. So if you want to predict Fahrenheit, then it is 9 by 5 Celsius plus 32. So when you give one input value, you can predict the other input value, and this equation is always perfect. This equation is always perfect. I'm sorry. These equations are always perfect. That means when you give one value, it exactly calculates the other variable value, and it gives the correct precise answer. So these kind of relationships are called as deterministic relationships. Then what is statistical relationship? Statistical relationships are those which do not have a perfect relationship between the variables. Perfect means these are perfect. It cannot go little up or down, nothing, no variations. It is exact value. Whereas, for example, when the height of a person is increasing, will the weight of a person increase? As the year of experience is increasing, can one person's salary increases? As the year changing, or if the square feet is varying, whether the price of the house also will be varying or not. So such values, when you predict, it need not be perfect, and it will not be perfect always. There will be always some ups or downs, some differences will be there. So such of those relationships are called as statistical relationships. And in this linear regression, we are going to discuss about statistical relationship and not about this deterministic relationship. So we are not going to discuss about the deterministic relationships. Okay, and why it is two, this linear regression, we always going to consider about two variables only. If you have more variables, then we are going to discuss that using another regression function that is called logistic regression function. So for two variables, we have only linear regression method. And then next is continuous variables. I think all of you know about discrete and continuous. So when you say continuous, then the number, say for example, 3.14, this is a pi value, this is a continuous value, because I think you know it is a continuous value, and then between every value there are infinite number of values. That means between 0.1 to 0.9 there are infinite number of values, whereas if I say 3 or 3.5, then that's it. You will not have any other number beyond this, so they are discrete, whereas here it is a continuous value. Okay, so we are going to discuss about continuous values and what is meant by quantitative. These continuous values are quantitative. That means these kind of values. Then what else is available other than quantitative? The other one is qualitative. Qualitative means we can tell in terms of good or bad, yes or no. And then if you are trying to classify the gender, then male or female. All these are called as qualitative variables. So we are not going to take any of these qualitative variables, because we are going to discuss on the quantitative variables. That means numerical variables, and that too they are continuous variables we are going to discuss. Okay, so if you want to perform any discussion on the qualitative variables, then we have to go for a classification technique. Okay, classifying into male or female, and then yes or no kind, whether the person has a cancer or not a cancer. That means binary classification, like that. Okay, so this is the introduction about the regression technique, and then the linear, why, and let us discuss why it is called as a linear. There is something called non-linear also, or quadratic or cubic. There are several types of representation of the variables, isn't it? I can write y equal to mx plus c. That is, all of you know the equation of a straight line. All of us know the equation of a straight line, and I hope all of you will agree with me that this is a linear line. And similarly, there is a quadratic equation, cubical equation, and so on. So here, when you say linear, what does it represents? That means, of course, you have a polynomial of a degree 1, and that is one thing. And then when you say linear, it actually refers to the fact that when one variable increases, what will happen to the other variable? And then when one variable decreases, what will happen to the other variable? So is there any relationship between the two? What is the trend that is happening between the two? So that is what we are going to discuss, and that is how the word linear is associated with. Now, in this equation of a line, all of us know this x, we call it as an independent variable. And this y, we call it as a dependent variable. So, and m is the slope, and c is the y-intercept. So now, why do we call this x as independent and y as dependent? For any value for x that you substitute here, you can compute the value of y, and you should know the value of c and m. Okay, so if those constant values are given, and for any value of x you can compute the y. So if assume you are given a value for M and C. Now I give a value for X, you can compute a value for Y. I give another value for X, you can compute Y. So we can draw a straight line like this. So this is a line that we have obtained by calculating the value for Y. So when you give X, you can predict Y. So let us use the word predict. Now onwards, we will be using the word predict or prediction very often. So when you give value for one variable, we can predict the value for another variable. Okay, so the one that is independent or the one that is given as an input, this does not depend on Y, this does not depend on any other constant variable. So that is called as an independent variable. And this Y, we are predicting based on the value of X. The value Y, what we are going to predict is actually dependent on the variable X. So that is why this is called as dependent variable. And then this this is the usual terms that we generally use, independent and dependent. And I also prefer to use as independent and dependent variable, as we are more often used the same terms. But generally in the machine learning community, instead of independent and dependent, the very commonly used terminology is actually predictor and explanatory. Predictor and explanatory variables. And then this is called as response or outcome. Okay. So we can use any of the terms, but generally it is better we will always remember what is independent and what is dependent. Okay. So now, for example, if I take the trend of the say, for example, if I take I think all of you know regarding this population and sample in probability. Earlier you would have studied about population and sample, right? So let us take one example from that and then we'll move on. In the course probability and random process or probability and statistics, maybe in your earlier courses you would have studied about population and sample. Okay. Suppose if I want to find the impact of higher education in India, then I cannot go to all the graduates in the country and then do a survey. Whereas I can only draw few samples from each state of India, then I can give a questionnaire or I can verbally pose some question, collect the data, and then I can record impact of higher education in India like that, isn't it? So when you have the entire population, it is difficult to extract the information what is required. So what we do is we draw certain samples. And from the samples, we conduct our survey in the form of questionnaire or whatever, verbal or written. In any form, we can collect our survey for the sample. And then based on the sample, we can give an estimate. Okay. In the similar example, what I have given earlier, like if I want to find whether I will get an admission into this college, then based on the past year data for the previous year, say the GATE score or the GRE score and then TOEFL score and then CGPA of the graduate, or this is one example. Similarly, for the experience and then the salary, based on the past data which I have collected, I have all the past data. Now I need to take the help from the machine learning, from the machine which is already learned. So now I am going to ask the question to the machine, okay, which is very intelligent and which is performing this prediction for me. See, look, now this is my experience. Now for my experience, how much salary will I get? it is simply like a C program or a Python program. I just give one value for the experience and I should get the salary predicted given by the computer, isn't it? Similarly, if I give my GRE score or if I give my CGPA or if I give my plus two cutoff marks, then I should know whether will I get a seat in this particular college or not. Okay, so so something like that I wanted to know. Right, so for that we have to collect the data from the past. From few people we have to collect the data and then we have to create a model and keep so that next time any new input data is given, the system should able to predict the value for me. So for all the previous year and then the house rate, the land rate there, it has to have a table with the two columns X and Y, as I said. So X is my independent variable, that is the year, and then Y is my dependent variable, say the price. Usually what we are going to predict is will be in the left hand side, will be the Y. Okay, so if I want to predict my salary, if I'm giving an input as my experience, then for this experience what will be the salary. So I have to collect from some 10, 20 people or some 100 people, I have to collect. And just by collecting the data, how I am getting an estimate. So with the data that is being collected, we have to write a program or we have to have a model, a machine learning model, which should help me to predict for any unknown or any new input value that is given. So how do we create a model? So the model that we are going to develop, that is usually based on a logistic regression technique, and that is usually based on a straight line, which is a linear line. So that is why we are going to use the term linear regression, because using a straight line, we are going to predict. And what is that straight line? How we can use that straight line to predict? So for example, earlier there was a study which was conducted in many countries, or even in India nowadays for this COVID-19, we are actually conducting so many surveys. Now there are a lot of data that is being available. Those who are interested can take any data nowadays for all the machine learning enthusiasts. Lot of data has now been generated because of this COVID. Say for example, because of certain condition, because of certain condition is the COVID-19 cases are increasing. Okay, so what is the condition? Is the COVID-19 count is increasing? Is the people getting affected by that is increasing? Then it is a positive trend. Suppose if given this condition, if the suppose given a vaccine is given now, then whether the COVID-19 cases will reduce? Yes, it can reduce. So for reducing, we can have a negative trend, and then for increasing, it can be a positive trend like that. Or for example, in a particular country, say the mortality rate. And then say this is the latitude. So when the latitude is increasing, the mortality rate is decreasing. That means for the people living in higher latitude, then the death rate is less. Whereas people who are living in the north region or in the lower latitude region, when they are more exposed to sun or whatever, when they are more exposed to cold or winter or sun, then the mortality rate is high. So we will know that, okay, now suppose if I'm going to this particular region and live there for 20 years, then whether my lifetime will be improving or how do I know? So basically there is a trend that is happening. So all that will be defined based on some sample data. So first we are going to discuss about this line, then we are going to take some sample data and then we are going to discuss this regression. So far we have done only the introduction part. Is it clear? Is the introduction part clear? Now shall we go on to the actual topic? Any doubts so far? Are you all listening?
Yes, ma'am.
And one question I would like to ask here. I have three lines like this. Say line 1, line 2, and then line 3. Now this is a 45 degree line. This is a 45 degree line. That means my y equal to x line. This is my y equal to x line. So when x increases, y also increases. And can you comment on this line and this line? What will be the slope of this line and what will be the slope of this line? So this is my dx and this is dy and this is dx and that is dy. So in this line, the slope dy by dx will be larger. Say this distance is 8 and this distance is 2, means then 8 by 2 is 4. Suppose if this distance is 8 and dy is 2, then it is 2 by 8, this is 1 by 4. So when you have the y difference, the gradient in y more and the gradient in x is less, then you will have a slope less than 1. Let us assume positive, and this one is a slope value which is greater than 1. Okay, and this one is a line where your slope is equal to 1.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay, I think all of you are very well aware of this concept. Slope less than 1, slope equal to 1, and then slope greater than 1. I'm sorry.
Should be the other way, right?
This is greater than 1 because your dy by dx will be greater. This is smaller, so this will be less than 1. So let us assume this is 8 and this is 2. So dy by dx will be 8 by 2, 4, which is greater than 1. And this will be 2 by 8, 1 by 4, it is less than 1. Okay, so you have slope value. I'm assuming a positive value. Sometimes it could be a negative value also. Here I have assumed absolute value for the slope. It could be a negative value also. So basically the slope can be greater than 0 or less than 0 or equal to 1. So we need to discuss based on these slope values also. Okay. So the slope value also gives an important contribution for the prediction. Okay. So now let us assume some data. So any doubts so far, please tell me. Kindly be interactive. Any doubts so far? Are you all listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No doubts.
Why nobody is talking?
No doubts, ma'am.
You can unmute and speak. Shall we proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Nikhil, Ashwin, Sai Pranati, Kailash, Haripriya, Shruti,
yes, ma'am.
Yashwant, Sai Ritesh, yes, ma'am. Prashanti, Sriram,
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Okay. Fine. Okay, so now in this prediction, we need to discuss about the line. And in general, this equation is considered as B0 plus B1. That means my intercept is considered as B0 and slope is considered as B1. So here we are going to have a statistical relationship. Though it is linear, they fall under the category of statistical and not deterministic, because the variables are not very perfect. The values that we predict is not always perfect. So when you say it is not perfect, what will happen? There can be some difference between the actual value and the predicted value of the model. So when you say model, what does it means here? Why we are calling it as a model? Okay, now for example, let us take height and weight. I have shared one link. By chance, did you all go through? You can open the link. If you have taken the PPT, in the last slide, I have given the link. You can take that link and you can keep it open. Say I am calculating the weight based on the height. Okay. Now let us assume we want to calculate the weight based on the height. Okay. So now all the past data means from some sample I am collecting the height and then the weight. So for the, let me assume the height and then the weight. Say for this height, the weight is predicted like that. I am drawing a line like this. Sometimes, and please remember, this line I am drawing based on one set of value of B0 and B1. The value of B0 and B1 can take any values, need not be always strict to a particular value. Now, if I change the value of B0 and B1, I will get a different line. If I change the value for B0 and B1, I will get a different line. So for the given height, I can predict the weight using any set of B0 and B1. So how do I know that which line is the best line? So we have to know the best model. That means the value best is very important. That means given the input values, I have to fit all those values into a line, and then that fits this equation the best. Okay, the value, input value should be fitting in this particular equation in such a way that I get the best value for W instead of all the three. That means if I have multiple values for B0 and B1, I can find the best value for B0 and B1 in such a way that my prediction is the best. When will you say your prediction is the best? When the actual value and the predicted value will not have much difference. Okay. Say for example, the program that I write to classify, to estimate the same the salary. Suppose the classifier or say the model that I have developed, the program, it is telling I can get a salary of 25,000. But then when I go to the company and attend the interview, they are telling for your experience, we can give you 26,000. Or another company is telling, we can give you a salary as 30,000. So the model has predicted 25,000, but then actually I am getting 30,000. So there is a 5,000 rupees error is coming. And another one, 1,000 rupees error is coming. So what we need to do is, we need to develop the model in such a way that the error value should be very less or very minimum. So out of all the three different lines, I can have infinite number of lines through some set of points. If I have one point, say a curve like this, and if I have a point, I can have any number of lines, a tangent that can touch the point, any number, isn't it? So now out of all this, similar way, out of all these lines, I can have any lines which is passing through all these points, isn't it? So out of all these lines, which line is the best line? So that I need to decide. So how I am going to decide the best line? Okay, so that also we need to discuss. So this value yi is actually the value that is being predicted. Now let me assume another variable yi. This is the actual value or the actual salary that I'm going to get, whereas this is the predicted salary. So when you subtract this yi and this yi cap, okay, this we call it as error. Okay. And this error value should be minimum. This error value should be minimum. And we are also using a square, because to give a positive value, not only to give a positive value, if you have a set of samples, then if this is negative, there can be another value of the same quantity with the positive. So minus and plus will get neutralized and you will not get a total value. Okay. So for that reason, we always square this. I hope you have understood this, why we are squaring. Okay. So the actual value and then the predicted value, you are subtracting and then squaring it. So that is actually called as the error E. And that value should be minimum. Then only the model that you can call it as the best model, and the line that you fit using the values also, you can call it as the best fitting line. Or you can call it as line of best fit. Okay. So this is the idea. So now let us take one example. And we'll see how to reduce this error and what is the concept behind this calculation and how to find the best line. Okay. I will share my screen and then show the example which is there in the reference link, and I will explain through that. So let us see here. I think you all can see the screen. So let us take one example. Given a height, predict the weight. So here there are two lines that are shown. Okay, one is a solid line, another one is a dotted line. So out of these two lines, we have to find which line is the best fit. Okay, so now let us have some information like this. The input value x and then the actual value and then the predicted value. Okay, now if you see the this is the actual value and this is the predicted value. So when you find the difference between y and yi, this is 10.9 and then the square is made here. So likewise, it is computed for all and then you get the sum of such yi minus yi cap whole square is calculated, that is giving this value. Similarly, for another line, okay, the solid line, the first one was for the dashed line, the next one is for the solid line. So given the same data, but the prediction values are different. In the xi and yi value are same, the prediction only different because the b0 and b1, the slope and then the y-intercepts are different here. If you observe the slope value here, it is 7.1 and then the intercept is minus 331.2. Here it is different. So now for these set of values also, it is computed and it is giving 597.4. Now you find the sum, this is 597.4. Here the sum is 766.5. Now out of these two, which line gives the lowest error?
The solid line.
The solid line, yes. So in this case, we have to take the model, the second one, the solid line. So we have to ignore the first one. So we have to take this intercept value and this slope value, the b0 and b1 we should take because this is giving the minimum error. Okay. So likewise, there could be many lines. So we have to find out from this. So that is the idea of doing the linear regression. That means since this is a linear regression, we have to use straight line. And then the relationship between the height and then the weight is given like this. So similar to height and weight, we can use anything like say for example the employee's experience, you can predict the salary likewise. Okay, so the error equal to yi minus yi cap and then we are subtracting and squaring, we have to sum it up for all the sample data and then we are doing like this, and this line is called as the line of best fit. Okay, and then how do we derive at the value b0 and b1? We are not going to do any derivation for this, but these values are given, taken from the calculus, methods of calculus. So I will do this simple step. Or it is time up. Okay, I can just show from this link only now, as of now. So for y cap, we already have the equation. For y cap, we already have the equation b0 plus b1 xi. So that we are substituting in this location. So in place of y cap, we are substituting b0 plus b1 xi, we are substituting. Okay. And then when you simplify further, it is mentioned that we have to take the derivative with respect to b0 and b1, set it to 0 and solve for b0 and b1. So we are not going to do that. It is already done and it is given here. So we'll follow as it is. So b0 equal to y, and this y bar is actually refers to mean, okay, minus b1 x bar. So it is y mean and x mean. And one more formula for b1, that is the slope. It is the xi minus x mean into yi minus y mean divided by xi minus x mean whole square. That means when you have the value for each element, we are finding the x mean here, and then for each element we are finding how far this value 63 is deviating from the mean, and similarly for yi how far this is deviating from the y mean. So this we are finding, okay, and then you have to perform a simple arithmetic. Okay, so now if you find this denominator xi minus x bar whole square will always give a positive value. Okay, so this is always, the denominator is always a positive value. So the value of the slope b1 actually comes from the numerator now, xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar. So the value of slope, whether it is greater than 0 or equal or less than 0, that means a positive value or a negative value, all that depends on the numerator. Okay, that means when x increases, whether y will increase, or when x decreases, whether y will decrease. All that depends on the numerator now. Okay, and then this line, we call it as the least squares regression line or least square line or estimated regression line. We usually call it as least square line and also the best fitting line. Okay. And then here there is a video, so I recommend you all to watch this video. This is a 1 minute video which explains you the value for greater than 0 and less than 0, all the conditions. So you can watch this video and then read this and come for the next class. Coming Friday, let us solve problems based on this. Let us take examples and let us solve on Friday. Friday, 2 hour slot, so let us solve problems for this. Okay. So probably, I think we have 2 more minutes, so let us watch this video. Okay, I have not enabled the sound. Just a second. Can you able to hear?
No, ma'am.
No, okay. Actually, I'm also not able to hear. Probably it actually talks about the trend for these values only. Maybe you can watch it little later. I hope the concept is understood well. So shall we stop here for today's class and we'll continue on Thursday for the next class?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, ma'am.